there is a deadlock in this section. What is the deadlock means? P0 has executed one line of code, only one line of code. I will initialize again. So here I will be initializing S0, S1, S2, S3, S4. Okay. 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. Okay. So these are the values which I have initialized. Now if P0 want to take F0 and F1, then he need to down these two values. P0 has performed this down operation and taken F0. Okay, and he is about to perform this second instruction, but at that time only P1 came. And what P1 has said, P1 also executed this instruction. As P0 has not executed this instruction, he can easily down this value and P1 can take the S1. Now P0 has taken S0, that is F0, and P1 has taken S1, that is F1. In the same way, P2 also, before P1 executes the second instruction, again P2 came and P2 made it down, the value down, and has taken the S2. And P2 is about to execute this instruction, again P3 came and P3 made it as down and taken S3, that is F3. Okay. When P3 is about to execute this second instruction, again P4 came and executed the first line of instruction and made it down, decrease the value to 0, and has taken S4. Okay. So here what happens, as already S1 is there, F1 is there, P1, P0 cannot take S1. So this creates a deadlock. So when will these people will leave this one? If P4 gets these two values, these two forks, and after eating, it will leave, it will put back the forks again. But it will never get the S0. It will never get the F0 because P0 has already taken S0. So it will never get that F0 fork. So it is nothing but a deadlock. Then how to clear this deadlock? For to clear this deadlock, there is only one solution, that is you have to reverse these values. Means for all these remaining philosophers, you need to execute in a sequential order, but only for the P4, if you reverse the value like S0 and F4. Means every time whenever philosopher want to eat food, he will be taking the left side fork first and then the right side fork. But coming to the P4, actually he has to take the left side fork F4 and then right side fork F0. But here, reversing the order, P4 has to take the right side fork, that is F0, and then the left side fork F4. Okay, by doing this, you can resolve the deadlock situation. How you will remove this deadlock means, again I will initialize values here for the clear understanding from starting. So all these have initialized with 1. Okay, so here what happened, P0 down the value and has taken S0, F0, and S1 P1 also down the value and has taken S1, that is F1. Only first line of instruction is executed by all these. By making down, P2 has got F2, that is this one. And for S3, P3 has come and executed the first line of instruction, made it 0. And it is about to execute this instruction, but P4 has come. And now what happens? As we have reversed the values, P4 now will go for S0. So can it take S0? No, because S0 is already with P0. F0 is already with P0. So P4 philosopher cannot take S0. Then what happens? This process is blocked. Okay. okay, this process will be blocked before, because already F naught is there with the P naught, so P4 cannot take the F naught. So this process is blocked. So now which is free? S4 is free. S4 is initialized with 1, but no philosopher has made it down. No philosopher has decreased the value. Now who is waiting for S4? Here who is waiting for F4? Philosopher 3. Philosopher 3 is having S3, F3 in his hand, but waiting for F4. Okay. Now what happens soon after blocking this process? Philosopher come and will execute the second line of instruction. Okay. P3 already executed this instruction and has taken S3, that is F3 fork. Okay. Now he is waiting, is about to take the S4. But soon after executing this one, P4 has come. That is why at the last time he cannot take in. But now as this process is blocked, when P3 has executed this first line of instruction, and he will easily execute this instruction by making S4 value down. Okay. Now P3 will be inside the critical section. Okay. Now P3 will be inside the critical section. And after eating, what happens? P3 will come out by putting the forks back, by making these values up. What values? S3 and S4. Means S3, S4 again became 1. Okay. So now whoever the philosophers are waiting for S3 and F4 will be executed. Who is waiting for S3? P2 is waiting for S3. P2 will be executed. P2 is already having S2. Now is waiting for S3. So now P3 has easily can down the value to 0 and he can take the fork 3. After executing again, he will put back the fork by executing this up. Okay. Again it is S2 and S1 will be initialized with 1 again. So this is how P1 and P0 also will be executed. At last, again, after putting back the F0 and F1 fork by P0, P4 will get a chance to take the S0, that is F0 fork. And finally, P4 will also be executed. Okay. This is how you can resolve the problem of dining philosophers. The only thing you have to remember is, at the same time, two philosophers can be in the critical section if they are independent. Okay. And by reversing these two values, you can avoid the deadlock situation present in this code. Okay. This is all about dining philosopher problem. Thanks to author that there is no problem with the food bowl. Okay. Thank you.